about my journey, and I found that I am very common man. I am aam aadmi, born and brought up in Jharkhand, one small town. Then setting aim to become an engineer, started writing entrance exam for engineering college. For my problem was not the what is the solution. For me, problem was the what is the question. Then somehow got the admission. Then again struggle started during campus selection. Again somehow got the campus selection, got one offer. Then this way life is keep on going. And then I moved to Mumbai Thane. And there I lived for 3 years. There I somehow found my life is that 3 years is golden period. I was financially independent. I can take my own decision. And then I then moved to Pune. I have been in Pune for 5 years. Then during this lockdown, I'm in my now hometown. I felt that I belong to here. Someday in down the line, after 5 or 10 years, I would like to settle down here and start something own business. That is whole my story. Welcome to 311th chapter meeting of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest. My name is Abhinav. I am sergeant at arms for today's meeting. I work at Cummins. My hobbies are reading and traveling. Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest provides learning and supportive environment in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence. Let me explain few basic rules. Please turn off your cell phone or turn it to silent mode if you are not using for meeting. Mute your microphone unless it is instructed by TMOD. Please keep your video on. And whenever you want to move on, please turn your video off in advance. Please don't share your screen unless it is instructed by TMOD. Please use emoji to react, thumbs up or smiley. Pin your timer window so that you can know the exact timing. Correct protocol to greet is, good morning, area director, madam president, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. We all must follow these rules. Let us start with round of guest introduction. Any guest is available here? Okay, no guest? Okay, we can move ahead. Now let me introduce Toastmaster of the Day. Toastmaster of the Day is someone who works at Byju's and her hobbies are reading and playing badminton. Let us welcome Toastmaster Ritija.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhinav. Good morning, Madam President, Area Director, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Welcome to another zestful program of fun and learning at the 311th chapter meeting of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest. I am Toastmaster Ritija, your host for this meeting. Coming to the theme for today's meeting, like any Toastmaster of the day, I thought a lot about what the theme should be. Something that's exciting enough for everyone, like aliens or the US presidential elections, and yet something that leaves an impact on the audience long after the meeting is over, like the year 2020. And so here I am with a theme that is both overrated and yet in many ways underrated. And it goes like this. What's your story? All of us have stories about ourselves. We tell stories about ourselves, and these are stories that define us. To know someone well is to know their story, the experiences that have shaped them into who they are right now, the trials, the turning points in life that have tested them. When we want someone to know us, we share our stories, stories of our childhood, of our family, our school years, our first crushes, hobbies, and so on. We shape our stories, and in turn, our stories shape us. On this note, let me brief you with today's agenda. Today's meeting will be divided into two parts. The first half of the meeting will consist of the election of the upcoming XCOM, and this will be followed by the prepared speech and the evaluation. The next will consist of a zestful table topics round by our table topics master for today, Toastmasters Swati. I urge all members to nominate themselves for this impromptu session. The impromptu session will obviously be followed by the reports, which will be towards the end of the meeting. Today happens to be an exciting day in the story of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest. Today, as we host our 311th chapter meeting, we also hold the elections for the upcoming XCOM term, that is from January 2021 to June 2021. Toastmasters is often at first glance seen as a public speaking platform, but is actually a leadership development platform as well, thus giving us the best of both worlds. There are plenty of opportunities that Toastmasters gives to develop your leadership abilities, and serving as a club president happens to be a major one of them. The XCOM, or the executive committee, consists of 8 members in all. These are your club president, the vice president for education, vice president membership, vice president public relations, the secretary, treasurer, sergeant at arms, and the immediate past president. The club needs an array of leadership planning to function well, and the XCOM performs various duties to ensure that the club runs successfully. So I now invite our area director, Toastmaster Joylin, for handling the elections. Over to you, sir.
Hi, good morning, everyone. I'm sorry, is there a confusion here? Aina, am I to do the elections or you are doing the elections?
Yes, Joylin. Joylin, your volume is a little lower. So I'll take...
Are you doing the elections, right?
I'm doing the elections, yeah.
Okay, Ritija, Hina will be doing the elections. I'll be back to do the installation ceremony.
Sure. Okay. Thanks. Thank you, Joylin. So very, very good morning to all present today. With immense pleasure, I take this opportunity to conduct the elections for the term January 2021 to June 2021. So, giving you a little background conduct the interviews and to finalize on the nominations, an election committee was formed, which consisted of 3 members, Toastmaster Manpreet Kaur, who was the election chair, Toastmaster Hina Sharma, who was the election officer, and DTM Hemant Arora, who was the election committee member. We thank the election committee for taking all the proceedings that were required for the nominations. So the mails were rolled out and we received nominations for different roles from the club members. The election committee then conducted their interviews, spoke to them, and we finally have the nomination list as proposed by the committee today. So I will now be starting with the election procedure. I'll be announcing the name and the role for which the committee has nominated the member. However, if any one of you who would like to contest for that particular position or the role, they may please come forward. We will then be moving ahead with the speech to find out the final nominee. Taking a glance at the quorum today, we have around 16 members present. The club strength is 32 members, and out of them 26 to 27 are our regular members, so therefore we are good with the quorum with 16 members. I see one guest here, otherwise we have 15 members. Joylin, are we okay with the quorum here?
Yes, we are good to go.
Wow. Thank you, Joylin. So I start with the first role, the member who would be, who has been nominated by the election committee to lead the club for the next 6 months. The election committee has nominated Jai Singh as the president for the club for the term January 2021 to June 2021. Do we have anyone who would like to challenge this for this role? Do we have anyone who would like to challenge themselves to contest for this role? Anyone who would like to contest or challenge for this role? Okay. So the election committee is glad to announce Jai Singh as the president of the club for the year, for the term January 2021 to June 2021. Congratulations, Jai.
Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you. I now move on to our next role, our VP education role, and election committee has nominated Toastmaster Swati as the VP education for the term January to June 2021. Do we have any member who would like to contest or would like to challenge for this role? Any member from the club who would like to contest for the VP education role? Any member who would like to contest or challenge for the VP education role? Amazing. Congratulations, Swati. So election committee and the club nominate Swati as our VP education for the term January to June 2021.
Thank you so much, everyone.
May I request, I think I missed something. So for, even for the president role, may I request our secretary, Pawan Deshpande, to please cast his vote.
Yeah, I cast a vote for the president, Mr. Jai Singh, and vote for VP Education, Toastmaster Swati.
Thank you. Thanks a lot, Pawan. Okay, we move on to our next role, which is the VP membership role. And the election committee has nominated Toastmaster Shashwatam as the nominee for VP membership. So do we have any member from the club who would like to nominate themselves now or contest for this role? Do we have any member from the club who would like to stand for this role or nominate themselves for this role? Do we have any member who would like to contest or nominate themselves for a VP membership role? Amazing. Congratulations, Toastmaster Shashwatam. And the club nominate you as our VP membership for the term January to June 2021. And may I please request our secretary to cast his vote.
Yeah, I cast my vote for Toastmaster Shashwatam.
Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster. The next role is VP PR. An election committee has nominated Venkatesh as the VP PR for January to June 2021. Do we have any nominations or anyone who would like to stand up for this role at this moment? Do we have anyone who would like to contest or challenge themselves to apply for the VP PR role?
VP Jam.
Any member from the club who would like to nominate themselves for the VP PR role to challenge the current contestant? Okay, so we do not have anyone. So, Secretary, may I please request you to cast your vote for our VP PR, Venkatesh?
I cast my vote for VP PR role for Venkatesh, Toastmaster Venkatesh.
Thank you. And we congratulate Toastmaster Venkatesh for being the VP PR for Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest for the January to June 2021 term. Our next role is for the treasurer. Election committee has nominated Toastmaster Pawan as their treasurer for the upcoming term. Do we have any contestant from the club for this particular role? Any member from the club who would like to stand and nominate themselves now for this particular role? Any member from the club who would like to nominate or challenge the current contestant that election committee has chosen? Toastmaster Pawan, as the secretary, may I please request your, you to cast your vote for the next treasurer, Pawan Deshpande.
Yeah, I cast my vote for the treasurer to myself.
Congratulations, Toastmaster.
Thank you, everybody.
Another stint at your...
Thank you, everybody.
The next role that we will have a nomination for is the secretary role, for which Toastmaster Abhishek has been chosen by the election committee. So anyone would like to contest for this particular role at this moment? Any member from the club who would like to challenge the current contestant chosen by election committee for this particular role? Any member from the club would like to stand for this particular role? Toastmaster Pawan Deshpande, as the secretary of the club, may I please request you to cast your vote for Toastmaster Abhishek as the secretary for the upcoming term?
I cast my vote for the post of secretary.
Thank you, and super congratulations, Abhishek, for your upcoming role in the XCOM for Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest.
Thank you.
Okay, last but not least, we come over to the SA role for the XCOM for upcoming term. Election committee is glad to choose Dr. Vinoda as the SA for the next term. Any member from the club who would like to challenge the current contestant chosen by election committee? Any member from the club would like to stand up for this particular role? Any member from the club who would like to stand for the SAR role for the next XCOM? Secretary sir, may I maybe please request you to cast your vote for the SAR for the next term for XCOM?
I cast my vote for the nomination. For the SA role.
Congratulations, Dr. Vinoda, for being the Sergeant in Arms for the XCOM for January to June 2021. And with this, we are glad that we have an XCOM for January, who will start from January 2021 and will take the clubs to the newer heights. So, I'll just re-announce the names once. The president would be Jay Singh, VP Education, Toastmaster Swati, VP Membership, Toastmaster Shashwatam, VP PR, Toastmaster Venkatesh, Treasurer, Toastmaster Pawan, Secretary, Toastmaster Abhishek, and for Sergeant at Arms, Dr. Toastmaster Vinoda. Congratulations once again to the entire XCOM. We trust in your leadership and we hope to see the club reaching greater heights with all of you working together. May I now request our installation officer, Toastmaster Joylin, to please take over the proceedings further.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Hina, for conducting the election process in such an efficient way. It was really good to see you guys doing it so nicely. I guess there's a network glitch at my end, so let me know if you guys can hear me clearly.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, DTM Vinod. Before I go, let me share my screen with you guys. Please let me know once you can see my screen. Are you guys able?
Don't your voice is a little low. But we can manage it if you cannot increase it.
Are you guys able to see my screen right now?
Yes.
Okay, so let's start. I'll be holding the mic very close to my mouth so that you guys are able to hear me clearly. Okay, we'll move on. We'll start with the installation ceremony for the Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest for the term of Jan to June 2021. Before we go off with the new set of officers, I would like all the outgoing officers to please note that from the 1st of January 2021, You will be discharged from all of your duties and responsibilities. Thank you for your excellent service to this club. Requesting everyone to give a big round of applause to your present executive committee. I am here to install the new officers of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest and briefly state their key responsibilities and to remind them of the challenges that lie ahead. Their collective challenge is to make this club one of the best in Toastmasters International. This will involve helping the members achieve their goals as well as leading the club to President's Distinguished Club status this coming year. I request the Zoom Master to spotlight the new officer team, beginning with the Sergeant at Arms and ending with the President as and when they are taking their oath. Each officer is obligated to attend the monthly Club Executive Committee meetings, attend the club officer training, which will be held twice a year, prepare a successor for his or her respective office. I will now describe the challenges and key responsibilities for each officer, beginning with the Sergeant at Arms. Requesting the Zoom Master to please spotlight the Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Vinoda. Toastmaster Vinoda, as Sergeant at Arms, you will arrange the meeting location, maintain the club equipment in working order, ensure that adequate club supplies are available, set up the room before the meeting begins, make all relevant educational and PR materials are displayed, attend to special equipment needs, greet the guests, and help the president make sure the meeting begins on time. Toastmaster Vinoda, will you perform these duties to the best of your ability?
Good morning, all. Yes, I am Dr. Vinoda. I will perform all the duties as told by you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vinoda. Requesting all of you to please give a big round of applause to your Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Vinoda. We now move on to the Treasurer, requesting the Zoom Master to please spotlight the Treasurer, Toastmaster Pawan. Toastmaster Pawan, as Treasurer, you will keep the financial records and prepare the club budget, announce when it's time for members to pay dues, explain the due structure to members, collect the dues, work with the secretary to ensure that the club submits dues promptly and on time to Toastmasters International World Headquarters. Toastmaster Pawan, will you perform these duties to the best of your ability?
Yes, I will.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pawan. Please give a big round of applause to the Treasurer, Toastmaster Pawan. Thank you. Zoom Master, will you please spotlight the Secretary, Toastmaster Abhishek? Zoom Master, can you spotlight Toastmaster Abhishek?
Toastmaster Abhishek, can you start?
I have some issue because of which I cannot open my webcam.
No problem, Toastmaster Abhishek. You can stay unmuted for the time being. Okay, Toastmaster Abhishek, as the secretary, you maintain an accurate membership roster and attendance. Submit the new club officer list to Toastmasters International by December 31st. Work with the treasurer to ensure that new members, applications and dues get to Toastmasters International World Headquarters as soon as possible. Work with the treasurer to submit your club's renewal dues to Toastmasters International on time and provide the club with minutes of each meeting. Toastmaster Abhishek, will you perform these duties to the best of your ability?
Yes, I will.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhishek. Please give Abhishek a big round of applause. We'll move on to the VP Public Relations. Zoom Master, if you could please spotlight Toastmaster Venkatesh.
Joyland, Toastmaster Venkatesh is not available today's meeting. He is not feeling well.
That is fine. So in that case, Toastmaster Hina, this is the oath you will have to take with Toastmaster Venkatesh when he will be available for the next meeting.
Sure.
I will move on to the next executive member, that is VP Membership. Can we please spotlight Toastmaster Shaswatam?
He's also not there. I'm not aware of the reason.
Okay, that is not a problem. Toastmaster Hina, Toastmaster VP PR and VP Membership need to take their oaths whenever they are available in the next meeting. Okay, we'll move on to the next, that is VP Education. Can you please spotlight Toastmaster Swati? Okay, thank you. Toastmaster Swati, as the Vice President Education, you gain commitments from members to set educational goals for themselves. Assure that the club members are aware of the schedule of meeting roles. Plan meetings that will assist members in meeting their goals. Work with club members to keep meetings fun and well run. Work with your club members to ensure that they submit their applications for educational awards promptly. Provide for educational topics at club meetings, such as those from the Successful Club Series and the Better Speaker Series. Represent your club at the Area Council meeting as the second highest ranking officer. Preside over the meeting when the president is absent. Toastmaster Swati, will you perform these duties to the best of your ability?
Yes, I will.
Thank you, Toastmaster Swati. Please give Toastmaster Swati a big round of applause. Moving on next, I would now like the Zoom Master to highlight the President, Toastmaster Jai Singh. Toastmaster Jai, as President of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest, you are the Chief Executive Officer. Thus, you will preside at all club meetings and all meetings of the Club Executive Committee. It is your challenge to see that this club adds new members and meets the needs of its current members to achieve their communication and leadership goals. Establish a club climate that is supportive, stimulating, and rewarding to all its members. Realize that amongst the resources available to you are your fellow club members, the club officer team, the club officer's handbook, the area director, the division director, the district 98 website, all other district officers. Toastmaster Jai Singh, you hold the gavel as a symbol of the power and authority that your club has given you during your term of office. I am confident that you will use it wisely and with restraint. Toastmaster Jai, as a member of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest, as well as its leader, will you work with the executive committee and club members to make Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest a President's Distinguished Club this year?
Yes, I will.
I would like to add one more point there, and I would like, as an area director, and I would like to see Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest not just be a President Distinguished Club, but also to achieve the Diamond Club status this year.
Yes, we will do.
Thank you so much. Please give Toastmaster Jai, your president, a big round of applause.
Thank you.
Now, dear club members, your officer team has just pledged to serve this club to the best of its ability. To be the best Toastmasters club possible and to meet the needs of all its members, your club will need active participation from each member. Do you, as members, pledge to work together with your officer team to make Toastmasters club of Pune Northwest the finest Toastmasters club it can possibly be?
Yes.
Yes, we will.
Yes, we will.
Thank you so much.
Yes, we will.
Thank you so much to all the members of Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest. By the authority vested in me as your area director, it is my sincere pleasure to declare these Toastmasters office installed in their respective club offices. Please join me in extending a warm welcome to the Toastmasters Club of Pune Northwest Club Executive Committee for the Toastmasters term of Jan to June 2021. Thank you so much everyone for inviting me here. I will have to take a leave because I have certain family commitments to go to today. So thank you so much and I will surely see you all in the future. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ritija.
Thank you, Area Director Joellen. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Joellen. We'll now be continuing with the meeting. So looking at the new XCOM, I'm sure that each one of them will play a vital role in taking the club to a new height. And we do look forward to know your stories as well. So getting back to the theme, life is all about the stories that we tell ourselves, right? In other words, we are the authors of our own lives. What we think, we act upon, and we make our reality. So what, according to you, is the most important element of a story, of your story or any story per se? I'd just like to know, you can type in the answers in the chat or something. Or else, just think it in your mind because it's Sunday and I get if everyone doesn't want to type it. So, in general, I think it's either your the stories, characters, or your transitions. Okay. Conflict. Learning from be ourselves. Be yourself. Okay. So, okay, that's nice. Kahani mein twist. All right. So before we go ahead, I'd just like to do a small time check. It is 11:33 and according to the agenda, we are right on time. So since we have a little time right now, before the role player's introduction, I'd like to play a small game. And this being the day for the newly elected XCOM, this is a small game I'd like to play with the XCOM itself. Raise your hands or just give me a thumbs up if you all know the game called 5-second rule. Okay, Toastmaster Hina does. So here what we'll do is that I will be asking a question to a certain member and you have 5 seconds and you have to name three things, the first three things that come to your mind. So I'll be sharing my screen so that you know what time it is and I'd like everyone to participate, but I will be starting with the XCOM. So please tell me if my screen is visible to all of y'all.
Not yet.
Just 1 second.
Yes.
It's
now visible.
Okay. So who should we start with? How about Toastmaster Hina, because she knows the game. Toastmaster Hina?
Sure.
Okay, so you have 5 seconds. The timer will be starting somewhat like this. And you have to answer the first three things that come to your mind. The buzzer will start. I mean, the buzzer will ring at exactly 5 minutes. So suppose, for example, if I ask you, name any three planets, you have to give me the answer in 5 seconds. But I obviously won't be asking you that now.
I can answer that.
Okay. So, Toastmaster Hina, name three things that you always forget.
The photograph after the bill.
Okay.
things. I don't forget much, actually.
Payment of bill, hotel bills.
No, I am sharp in memory a little, so yeah. Sorry? Okay, good.
Okay, so I'd like to have Toastmaster Vinoda next. Vinoda, ma'am, if you could please unmute yourself. Toastmaster Vinoda, are you there?
Yes.
Okay. Toastmaster Vinoda, name three Indian presidents.
Abdul Kalam, Modi, and Singh. Manmohan Singh, I mean, I said Singh.
President Modi.
Sorry.
Okay, it is not a very easy game. It might sound like an easy game. But okay, we'll have a little simpler questions. Okay. So is Toastmaster Pawan here?
No, I think he also had to leave after this elections.
Okay. Toastmaster Jay?
Okay. Sure.
Are you ready, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. Toastmaster Jay, name three gaming apps.
Gaming apps, PUBG,
okay.
Candy Crush, and Temple Run.
Wow. Okay. Okay, great. Toastmaster Swati?
Yes.
Okay. Toastmaster Swati, name three books that you like.
All of Sudhamurti's, Shweta and Million Dollars and Dollar Bahu. I follow her. I follow Sudhamurti's books. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster Swati. So, do we have Toastmaster Prabdeep? I'm not able to check my screen. Is Toastmaster Prabdeep there?
No, he's not there.
Okay. So Toastmaster Raghav?
Yes.
Okay. Toastmaster Raghav, name three languages that you consider difficult.
Ikkada screen lo ni chala dark ga kanapadutundi na.
I'm hearing background noise. Okay.
You weren't able to hear?
No. Someone is speaking. Okay.
Okay, I'll ask you another question.
No, I was.
No. Okay. Toastmaster Raghav, I'll ask you another question now. Name three things that make you cry.
Okay. Emotional movies, anything bad with related to family members or someone I know. And third, a baby or a pet, a small pet. I just got emotional by seeing a pet or a baby.
Okay. You guys have to answer within 5 seconds and we'll ask a few more. So do we have Toastmaster Abhishek?
Yeah.
Okay. Just 1 second. Toastmaster Abhishek, name any three Amitabh Bachchan movies.
Kuli, Buddha Hoga Tera Baap, and Sole.
Okay, within the buzzer. Okay, but not bad. All right. Do we have Toastmaster Shashwatam? No, we don't. Toastmaster Manish? Anyone else would like to give it a try?
Give it to me.
Okay.
Hemant.
Toastmaster Hemant? Name three things that should always be there in your fridge.
Cheese, paneer, and tomato.
Okay. That was a perfect answer within 5 seconds. Anyone else would like to try it once?
Abhinav.
Okay. Toastmaster Abhinav, name the last three food items that you've eaten.
Chai, coffee, namkeen.
That was quick. Okay. Anyone else?
Yeah, I'll try.
Okay.
Chai, coffee, namkeen, kaun peeta hai? Chai ya coffee peeta hai? Chai, coffee, namkeen.
It is my choice, my life.
Yes.
Okay. Toastmaster Vinod, name yes. three things that you should have when you are very old.
One is a stick, medicine, and clothes, sweater clothes.
Okay. Thank you. Anyone else?
Yeah, I can try. Anand here.
Okay. Toastmaster Anand, name three things that you love the most about your country.
Okay. Diversity and unity and okay.
Okay, you can name it anyway.
Culture.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster Anand. Any guest who would like to give it a try? We can have like one more go.
I can try. This is Harshada.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
This is Harshada. Maybe I can try.
Okay. Hi, Harshada.
Hi.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Harshada, just one second. Let me think of a question. Name three things that... just one second.
Sure.
Okay. Name three things, Harshada, that make you mad.
Lack of following traffic rules, garbage, and... my time is over. Thanks.
Okay. Thank you, everyone. I think we're on time now. So, getting back to the meeting, I'll now be introducing all the role players. So, for today's meeting, we have a timer. Let me introduce the timer. So, everything that we do in Toastmasters meeting is done under a time limit. And to keep track of time, we have a software engineer who loves coding, obviously, biking and swimming. Please welcome Toastmaster Abhishek. Next, in our speeches, we often use pauses and filler sounds such as as, and, but, you know, so. Sometimes these pauses and sounds are used for impact, but often there are times where we use these words as crutch words. So to keep a track of such unnecessary pauses or fillers used by the speakers, we have a doctor, anesthesist, and an intensivist. We would like to, our counter for today likes to read books and learn new things. Please welcome Toastmaster Vinoda. Next, we have an individual, we have individual evaluators for the speakers. We similarly have a general evaluator for the whole meeting who will be observing the proceedings and the environment of the meeting and will also evaluate all the role players. At the end of the meeting, he will give us his feedback and comments. To act as the general evaluator today, we have an engineer from Mercedes who loves reading and running. Let us welcome Toastmaster Jay. Next, we have, language is an internal part of public speaking. And to help us improve our linguistic skills and give us critical feedback on the language, we have a software engineer working from IBM. Our language evaluator loves writing blogs. Let us welcome Toastmaster Hina, who will now introduce to us the word and the phrase of the day. Over to you, Toastmaster Hina.
Yeah, 2 minutes. Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Ritija. As the language evaluator for you today, my job is to find out some of the misses in your grammatical or your grammatical errors and find out the good usage of the language as well. It's time for me now to introduce you to the word and the phrase of the day. And considering the fact that it was just shared with you yesterday, we have a word of the day which we would expect you to use in every sentence that you speak today. So the word of the day is zeal. Z-E-A-L, zeal. What does zeal mean? Well, it's a noun which means a great energy and enthusiasm. So anything, if you are portraying great energy or great enthusiasm, we say what a great zeal you have. As an example, his zeal and energy helped him achieve great success. And we have intentionally put just one example because we now want to have a couple of more examples from the team out here. So please come up with some examples for the word of the day, zeal.
Can I try?
Yes, yes, please.
No matter we are limited members today, but we completed election with the zeal.
Thank you to DTM Vinod. Anyone else would like to try? Or else I'll have to pick them up. Can we request some guest? Guest Harshada, would you like to try?
Yeah, sure. The meeting is proceeding with a great zest and zeal.
Thank you. That actually is a very great example.
Thank you.
We have another guest, Prathmesh. Would you like to try?
Yes. Hello. Will you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Anything we achieve in our life, it's only because of our zeal and passion.
Very nice. Very great example. Thank you, Prathmesh.
Thank you.
Yeah, so we can have one more last example and I...
Can I try?
Yes, please, Toastmaster Shantan. I was about to ask you.
Okay, thank you. So I'm always amazed with zeal of Toastmaster JC.
Great, great example. Thank you. Thank you, Toastmaster Shantanu. Well, the next is the phrase of the day. Which the phrase of the day today is the best of both the worlds. The best of both the worlds, which means that you can enjoy two different opportunities at the same time. I'll give you an example out here. By working part-time and looking after her kids for 2 days a week, she managed to get the best of both the worlds. Now, I hand it over to our members to come up with the good examples. Best of both the worlds. Toastmaster Swati, switch on your camera.
Yeah. The prepared speeches and table topics provide the best of both the worlds in the Toastmasters meeting.
Great. Thank you, Toastmaster Swati. DTM Vinod.
Yeah, today we have elections as well as speeches and roles also. So we are enjoying best of the both worlds.
Absolutely, we are. Thank you. Anyone else who would like to try? DTM Hemant. Best of both the worlds.
You put me in a spotlight. What do I say? So difficult. What do I say, man? Being part of XCOM and being also Toastmaster is best of both worlds. You are responsible, plus you also deliver speeches.
Totally agree. Thank you, DTM Hemant. Toastmaster Raghavendra, we'll have last example from you.
While working from home and also working for home, you can enjoy best of both the worlds.
Absolutely. And we are enjoying best of both the worlds. Thank you. Make sure whenever someone uses the word of the day, which is zeal, and phrase of the day, which is best of both the worlds, please ensure to give a thumbs up. And I will be back at the end of the meeting with my report. Thank you. And over to you, Toastmaster of the Day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Hina, for the word and the phrase of the day. So we will now be moving on to our prepared speeches session. Today, we have only one prepared speech for this session. The speech has certain fixed objectives and it is delivered in a specific time limit. Each project teaches us some aspect of public speaking, such as body language, persuasive skills, or vocal variety. The speaker will try to present the speech utilizing the skills they learned while preparing these speeches. Generally, we have a voting for the best speaker, but since we have only one speaker today,
we'll be having the speech, the evaluation, and then the table topics. The speaker is allowed, the speaker must speak for the minimum time allowed for his speech and must not exceed the maximum time allowed. However, a grace of 30 seconds will be given to the maximum after the maximum time is crossed. Our speaker for today will be attempting his level 1 project 4 research and presenting speech from the pathway Dynamic Leadership. The mentor of the speaker is Toastmaster Vijay, and the evaluator for the speech is DTM Vinod. I request Toastmaster Vinod to read out the objectives of the project.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ray of Ritija. The purpose of the speech is for this project is for members to learn or review basic research methods and present a well-organized, well-researched speech on any topic. All the best to speaker Raghvinder.
Thank you, DTM Vinod. The time allowed for the speech is 5 to 7 minutes, which means that the lighting sequence will be green at 5, yellow at 6, and red at 7. The buzzer will sound at 7.5 minutes. The title of the speech is The Secret of Becoming Great Leaders. The speaker is a mechanical engineer whose hobbies are reading, cycling, listening to music, traveling, learning new things, playing, and watching sports. Let us welcome Toastmaster Raghavendra. Over to you, Toastmaster Raghavendra.
Thank you, Ritija. Toastmaster of the day, Ritija. Am I audible and am visible?
Yes. Hello.
Yes. Thank you. I can also say time is back. The secret of becoming great leader. You all might be wondering now, what is this secret might be? I might not be the epitome of this secret, but I want to ask you people, ask you to guess what this secret can might be. This is a very well-known secret. You all must answer, might know. You can use the chat window to write your answer. Let me see what are the answer I get. No answer. This is the very old, you all must know this secret. Okay, so I will answer. The secret is reading. Reading. You all must have read this quote, readers are leaders. How many of you have a hobby as a reading? You can raise a thumbs up. And I want to ask, how many of you have read a book in last 1 month? And I see few of them. Great. You all must know the world, all the top leaders in the world reads book at least once a month or once a week, be it Bill Gates, Warren Buffett, Sundar Pichai, or Satya Nadella, or previous great leaders like Martin Luther King, or many more. They always have been a great readers. But why is that the reading improves? Why reading helps to becoming a great leader? Look, there are lots of the answers to the question, but I will like to cover a few of them. First, it increases knowledge. If you want to are a leader in few, you are a leader in particular field, it will reading will help to know that field very much better and how to improve on your thing, like the various book like book of Stephen Covey, 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, or how to make money, or start with why. So these are the few books, or there are many more. It will help to become a great entrepreneur, or how to be a leader team. So reading helps you to increase your knowledge. The second one is it increases creativity. Reading is an active thing. other than like listening to podcast or watching any informative videos. According to neurology, reading involves lots of our body senses, like our eyes. If you are using thumb or finger while reading the words, and also our brain cells. So when your lots of senses are involved in a particular activity, it increases your creativity. So as per Steve Jobs, he said, lots of great ideas came to him while he was reading certain article or something. So reading improves our creativity and helps us to give great new ideas to solve the problem. And one of the reason is it gives us escape. While our this busy schedule, some entertainment books will help, like to give escape from our world, and it will involve in that book's character, like the book Notebook or many more. So you will get involved in their own life and you will escape from your current world. So people read books of entertainment, for entertainment. Some read for vocabulary and some read because their friends, everyone in their friend circle is reading books, like me. Now, these are the various of advantages of reading books, but why we see that lots of people not reading books? Because very much people are not aware of things. Me, myself, until my engineering completed, I was never aware of such thing like reading books. I was always watching movies or TV series, but never came thought in my mind that there is a thing like if you read books, it will help you to improve yourself, it will increase your knowledge and other thing. Some people are aware of this thing, but avoid it because it requires lots of concentration and it's a lengthy process. Because in our busy schedule, we find that we are much aware of time. And if you get time of like 10 to 15 minutes, and if you start reading the book, it like in initial 5 to 10 minutes, you won't get that zest, or you will not have that zeal of reading book until you are all the concentration is achieved. And after when your all the concentration has fine, you will find that I don't have time, I have to do other tasks. So I want to give us some ideas that if start reading book slowly, start with few pages, 5-10 pages per day, and then increase it. Or like if you are like to listening podcast or watching videos, create it an active thing, not a passive thing. Like ask questions, why this person spoke this, why, what are the reasons, what for this particular statement. So when you will ask this question, you will find that you will be get involved in that particular podcast or that informative video. And also taking notes will make it more active and it will help. So main objective of the speech is that I want to request you all to start reading books listen to podcast, but actively. And when you will listen this podcast or read book, prepare your speech and deliver it next time. That's it. Over to your Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Toastmaster Raghavendra. Let us pause for 1 minute to write the feedback for the speaker. You can write and send your feedback to the speaker in the chat window privately, or you could send them via message on WhatsApp as well. Okay, we'll just pause for 1 minute for the feedback. By then, we can have the timers report.
Toastmaster Abhishek, if you can give us the exact timings of the speech. Like I said, there will be no voting because there's only one speech for today. But if you do want to test your impromptu speech, you know, thinking on your feet, I encourage you to give your names to Toastmaster Swati via the chat option itself.
So Toastmaster Raghavendra spoke for 7 minutes, 4 seconds.
All right. Okay, so we'll do a time check now. Right now it is 12 p.m. and according to the agenda, we are almost on time. So what we'll do is we'll take a break for 5 minutes, after which we can have the evaluation for the speech that was given. Okay, so it's 12 right now. We can join back at 12:05, 12:06.
Okay, so welcome back, everyone. Just to ensure everyone's there, could you please switch on your cameras? Thank you. All right. So now that we're all back, it's time for the evaluation of the speech given by Toastmaster Raghavendra. The evaluator will be giving a detailed feedback to the speaker at the end of the meeting. But he will also be giving a short feedback in 2 to 3 minutes here. The timing sequence is green at 2 minutes, yellow at 2.5 minutes, and red at 3 minutes. The buzzer will ring at 3 minutes and 30 seconds. The speech by Toastmaster Raghavendra will be evaluated by someone who has been working in logistics for 33 years. Our evaluator likes reading, dancing, and making new friends. Let us welcome Toastmaster Vinod for the evaluation now. Over to you, Toastmaster Vinod.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Ritija, Madam President, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests, good afternoon, and special good afternoon to my speaker, Toastmaster Raghavendra. The secret of becoming a great leader. When I announced this topic was announced, everybody hooked by this title, because we all are great leader. We are all are great leaders in this club. So everybody thought, what can be the secret? And they were thinking of the different reasons for the becoming a great leader. And finally, my Toastmaster, my speaker revealed the secret, that is, leaders are great leaders. So a great topic, and by asking a question with the audience is the best idea to engage the audience. So in the very first, by asking the question, he engaged the audience, the objective met. And speaker not only said that reading is a helping to great leader, but also he given the advantages, how many advantages we have, we can create creativity, we can have knowledge, we can increase our knowledge. Then he also engaged by asking many questions again and again. So kudos to you as far as the engaging the audience part is concerned. These are the great feedbacks, these are the great comments from my side, but there is a two feedbacks from my side. When a speaker is not prepared himself, then it's difficult to pass on the message, right? And it's a virtual meeting. If you are prepared well, if the speaker is prepared well, he can look at the camera, deliver the message, and give the message very clearly. So I personally felt that there was a little bit needed for the speaker to prepare, deliver his speech. And second, because of not preparedness, the voice always go flat or monotonous. There are many topics that speaker can change his voice modulation. Reading increase creativity. Reading increase knowledge. So this voice modulation could have been used. Overall, a great speech with a message is always works. And what our takeaway from us, that whenever you want to prepare yourself, read the books. If you are not reading the book in a day, read 5 or 10 pages, listen to podcast, and record your message and deliver the speech. That was a fantastic from your part. Overall, a great speech with the ideas and takeaway from the speech. Over to you, Toastmaster. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vinod, for your evaluation. So now we've come to the next part, the next session of our meeting, which is the table topic session. Let us test our ability to think fast and speak impromptu in the table topic session. For conducting the table topic sessions, we have a business analyst who enjoys singing and dancing. I would like to now welcome Toastmaster Swati to take over the table topic session.
Thank you so very much, Toastmaster of the day. And a very happy Sunday
to the presiding officer and to all the Toastmasters and to the guests present here. Table topics is the most crucial part of a Toastmasters journey. So now we are going to the most crucial part. Table topics will allow you to think on your feet and to become an impromptu speaker at the same time. And the best part of this session is even guests can participate. And to be eligible for the table topics, each and every speaker or the table topic speaker should speak for 1 minute. And at 1 minute, the green flag would be raised. And at 1.5 minutes, the yellow flag would be raised. And at 2 minutes, the red flag would be raised. And a time of 30 seconds as a phrase time would be given. And once it's done, the buzzer would be pressed. So each and everyone, I would like each and everyone to turn on your videos. So that let us show the gist, chill, and let us show the second part of the world of the Toastmasters. So I want each and everyone to turn on the videos. Thank you so much. So now who wants to go first? I would like to get the first nomination, and I think it's from our very dear president, Toastmaster Hina. Toastmaster Hina, are you ready?
That was a thumbs up for using the word of the day and phrase of the day.
Okay, not a problem. Thank you, Toastmaster Hina. So who wants to go first or who wants to participate first? Let me check. And even the Zoom master can help me out. First, I would like a Toastmaster to participate. Then we'll go ahead with the guest.
I can participate. Yeah, that's fine.
Sure. Toastmaster Hina, so your topic would be, it's now or never. So Toastmaster Hina, now or never. Now or never, Toastmaster Hina. Over to you.
Now or never, which means if you have to do something, you have to do it now or else you'll never be able to do. I was walking with my son and he asked me, Mom, can I buy that pencils, those pencils on the floor, in the shop that are there? I said, no, never. He said, Mom, I want to buy it now. So if you see, kids, they just know it. When it comes to playing games or when it comes to playing, you know, buying something or when it comes to eat chocolates. And that is the time when they are adamant. They just want it. But as you grow up, you tend to lose on that thing. You tend to start postponing your things. Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. And then that is the time when procrastination seeks in. This is one thing that I've actually learned from my kids. That if they have to do it, they have to do it. And at the same time, they will do it. But we tend to postpone it. And because of this postponement, if you have planned out something, that even doesn't go as you had planned it when you thought of it. It just happens. Secondly, because you procrastinate, you often delay. You often miss those deadlines. And this is, of course, I'm speaking with my personal experience, though I'm trying to better myself on that. But yes, we do tend to miss on things. So if you have to do it, we have to do it now. To have to go for a walk, start now. Go for, you know, even a 1 minute walk, but start now. And as our Kabira says, kije to aaj kal, kije to aaj kije, pal mein pal rahe ho. Bahuri karega kab. So I don't remember the exact, but yeah, that is there. So if you have to do it something, do it now. If you keep on postponing, it will never, never happen. And that's the reason we have now or never. Thank you, and over to you, Table Topic Master.
Toastmaster Swati, or on mute.
That was very wonderful, said Toastmaster Hina. And that was, in fact, a wonderful start to our table topic session. In fact, thank you so much. Now, next, we'll go ahead with our guest who has already nominated. Guest Harshida, are you ready?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you so much, thank you so much, guest Harshida. And your topic, as per the theme of the day, is my story. So your topic would be the best moment of your life. The best moment of your life, guest Harshida. Guest Harshida, the best moment of your life. Over to you.
Well, the best moment of the life was the moment that turned my life around altogether. I was in the 7th standard. And in the 8th standard, we were supposed to take either semi-English or Marathi medium. My mom said, if you don't go ahead with Semi-English, I will ensure that you sit at home, help me wash dishes and everything. You can't expect that your career flies while you being in your comfort zone. So you can't have best of both the worlds. You will have to have the zeal to do all the hard work that is required to do best in your career or in your studies. So I think that was the best moment of my life, because many a times we expect that things to flow smooth, things to be as comfortable as they can be. But a hero is just as good as the villain. The hero can't be expected. I mean, if Amjad Khan wasn't good, there is no praise for Jay and Veeru in Sholay, right? So you can just be as good as the bad moments and how you face those challenges that came your way. So I think the decision that my mom helped me take that day kind of changed my life. And that's why I think that was a moment for me. That kind of helped me move ahead with a lot of enthusiasm, zeal, and look at challenges in a very different manner. And that's why I'm really, grateful for having a strong mom who pushed me through my tough times and ensured that I'm not just being comfortable, because I was thinking like, if I take Marathi medium, I'll just be the topper of this class and I'll be good with the things which make me very comfortable. So that's pretty much it. Thank you.
Wow, that was very well said, guest Harshada. In fact, thank you. The challenges we face show us what we really are. So very well said, and kudos for giving us such a nice attempt. And now next, who wants to participate? Let us go to the next. Who wants to participate? And even the Zoom master can help me out.
I can try.
I can only hear the voice. May I know who was it?
Abhinav.
Abhinav. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Abhinav. So Toastmaster Abhinav, as Toastmaster of the day said, our story doesn't only depend upon the best moments, happier moments, but even depends upon the funny moments. So Toastmaster Abhinav, the funniest moment of your life. Over to you, Toastmaster Abhinav, the funniest moment of your life. Toastmaster Abhinav, the funniest moment of your life. Over to you.
Madam President, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests, good afternoon. My topic is funniest moment of my life. So there are many moments in life. Few are, you enjoy few moments, you become very sad, and few moments are full of fun, and that remains with you in your life. There are many moments. Those were gave me a lot of fun, but I remember one moment that I can say it is funniest for me. I was in fifth standard. Me and my cousin were in same class. The day result was announced, I didn't go to school. My cousin brother brought result of mine too. When he was coming to my home, I asked him how I performed in exam. He showed me 5 fingers. I thought my rank is 5th in class. When I asked him, how is your result? He showed me 2 fingers. I thought how he could do better than me. I thought he failed in 2 subjects. When I saw the report card, I was failed in 5 subjects. His rank was 2nd in class. And we all started laughing. And then same time my father entered in home and he scolded me like anything. So that was the funniest moment in my life that I remember. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
That was absolutely funny, Toastmaster Abhinav. And I think each and every one of us thoroughly enjoyed it. Thank you for sharing that. And it was, again, a wonderful speech. So let us go to our next Table Topic speaker. So who is the warrior now? Who wants to attempt next?
Anyway. I try next. This is Shantanu.
Shantanu. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shantanu. Toastmaster Shantanu, now let me give you as we are going through the story only, the story doesn't have just the funny moments and the best moments. We do have emotional moment. So the best emotional moment, Toastmaster Shantanu. Toastmaster Shantanu, the best emotional moment. Over to you.
Okay, the best emotional moment. Around 3 years back, I like music since my childhood, and I was really never following that very seriously after I started my job. But at one point in my career, I realized that I'm getting too much busy, and I should really give time for my hobbies. So at the age of 35, I started learning classical music and instrument, and I think I learned for 3 years, and after that, I got selected for one of the international competition. I participated in one competition in Singapore, and I won third prize there. So I feel that was the very emotional moment for me, because it was something that I was ignoring in my life. And it's your hobbies, if you're passionate about something, your life really changes, because it is something that will help you to be motivated throughout your life. It's not like you are just focusing on your hobbies or something. You can equally concentrate on your work and hobbies. So that is something that will make our life very joyful. So yes, that was about my emotional moment. Yes, thank you.
Wow, Shantanu. Wow, Toastmaster Shantanu. Even I could relate to that, being a singer. If somebody appreciates, it is actually very emotional. So thank you so much for sharing your moment, and very well said. So let us go to our next table topics. Before that, I would like to just do a time check. Toastmaster of the day, do we have enough sufficient of time, or how many speakers can we go ahead further?
Okay, so the time according to the agenda, just a minute, let me check.
Mm-hmm.
We can take about one or two more if there are participants. Yeah.
Sure. So we would go ahead, as we just have two guests, I hope, today. So we would go ahead to our next guest. Our next guest, Pratimesh, hopefully. Pratimesh, is he there? Zoom Master can also help me out in identifying.
Hello.
Guest Pratimesh?
Yes.
Pratimesh, would you like to participate?
Yes, I will try.
Sure, definitely. So Pratimesh, hero of, as we all know in our life or in our story of our life, we do have hero plays a most important role in our life.
Yes.
So according to you, hero of your life, Pratimesh, hero of your life. Over to you, Pratimesh.
Okay. First of all, I'm from Maharashtra. So for all Maharashtrians, the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj is a role model and a hero, because of his skills, ability to manage, and the leadership they give us. That's all an incredible part of our lives. We can learn different skills and the leadership skills and communication skills from him. That's why the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj is the role model of my own, the first role model of my life. That's it. Over.
Thank you so much, Pratimesh. That was, in fact, hey Shivaji, we all are from Pune. We all are currently from Pune, and even we all have immense respect for our great leader. That was very well said. Thank you so much, guest Pratimesh. And anyone else? We do have time for one more speaker. So anyone else who would like to take this chance of participating? Role players, everybody can participate. Last speaker.
Master Manu joined in from PTMC. Would you like to try?
Yes, sure.
Thank you so much. So Toastmaster Manu, usually our life is divided into two parts, family, friends, and professional life. So the best family moment, Toastmaster Manu, the best family moment, Toastmaster Manu, over to you.
Thank you, Table Topic Master Swati. The best family moment, the moment you were giving me the topic, the incidents or the trip that came to my mind was wherein I traveled to Trivandrum with my mom and my dad. So actually, we were on a trip, family trip. Only three of us were there. Other members couldn't join because there was my father actually was going through a lot of pain during that time. He was undergoing treatment for cancer. He had underwent a bypass surgery recently. And he wanted to meet his near and dear ones. So that trip was a really special trip. It was towards the end of his life. And the quality time that we spent together, those few days, is what came to my mind the moment you gave me that topic. I know some of you may feel that it's a sad thing that I lost him, but I'm glad that I got to spend quality time with him during those few days and the last stages of his life. So what that trip has taught me, or it's like an eye-opener for me, that when you reach the end stages of your life, what you realize is that you have wasted your life. And these were the last words of my dad when he was on his deathbed. He said that, Manu, all my life, I did a lot of things, but there were a lot of things which I kept postponing. I'll do it later once my son is settled or my family is doing well, then I'll start enjoying my life. But he said, now when I had everything, when I was in a position to enjoy, see what has happened. So it's a eye-opener, and I think all of us can take that message to live the life in the present moment. There is no guarantee of the next moment. So keep that in mind and live. Sorry, I was disconnected momentarily.
Not a problem. You can. I hope you were supposed to end it. You can go ahead, Manu. We are.
Yes. Thank you, Swati, for the opportunity. So that was the wonderful moment. So I urge all of you to make the most out of the time that you have with your friends, colleagues, relatives, because tomorrow is not assured. The only thing that is assured is your present moment. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
That was very well said and a lesson for the lifetime, Toastmaster Manu. And seriously, it's an eye-opener to each and every one of us to live in the moment and enjoy the moment. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts on it. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Manu. And I think Toastmaster, I think we can end here, or can we go for one or two topics as you suggest?
We can end now.
Okay. Thank you so much, each and everyone, for participating in the Table Topics with lot of enthusiasm. And each and every one of you were excellent. And now I can go to Master. Just.
Okay.
There are polls for all our Table Topics that we can vote for the best Table Topic speaker.
Yeah. So I would just like to confirm from the timer if all of the speakers have qualified.
Guest Pramthesh has spoken for 36 seconds. So other than him, all are qualified.
All right. So in that case, what we'll do is that I'll be launching the polls, and I request all of you all to vote for the others who have qualified here. I'll be launching the poll now. Request everyone to please put in their votes. Okay, two more people remaining. All right, we'll be closing the votes now. Okay, so now that we're done with the table topic session, the next what we have is the reports for today's meetings. It's time for the language evaluator to come forward and give her comments. Let us welcome Toastmaster Hina for the language evaluation report.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Well, how do you measure progress was one question that, you know, I normally think of whenever I am presenting a report on Toastmasters. And the way I personally measure it as, when in a language evaluation report, your numbers of bad usage decreases and the number of good usage increases. Well, that's what we saw today. While most of the speakers were actually flawless in using their grammatical sentences and all, we do have a few bad usages, which I'll just talk of. So someone used the word is keep on going. Rather than, you could have said that kept on going. Someone said belong to here. Rather than that, it could have been belongs here, or, you know, it belongs to this particular thing. Then have read a book. Now, this is the, you know, usage of the tenses here. So if you're talking about a tense, you have to understand tenses. And if you're saying have read a book, you actually meant who have read a book before in the past, right? So instead of read, the word goes as read. Are great readers? No, that was wrong. It should have been are great readers. And someone said that enough sufficient of time. The correct sentence could have been, do we have sufficient time? So these were a few, but we have beautiful usages of good words as well. Someone said epitome of success, epitome where you have reached good heights of success, zestfulness. Then we have fantastic. And there were a couple of more good words that were used. So all in all, overall from the language point of view, we actually had a very, very good meeting today. People or the members who used the word and phrase of the day. So we have three members who have used both the word and phrase of the day. And the members are Toastmaster Raghavendra, Toastmaster Swati, and our guest Harshada. Kudos to all of you to ensure that you've learned new words and phrase today, and you've included that as part of your, you know, regular speaking today. Toastmaster Ritija, I'll just need to borrow two more minutes. I have something to share.
Yeah.
Thank you. Give me a minute. I'll share my screen. Okay. So, how many of you have? So there's a comedian or stand-up comedian whose name is Abhishek Upamanyu. I'm not sure if you have listened to him. So he was actually talking about one of an instance where, you know, one of his friends was actually vomiting, and he goes to his friend and he says, oh my God, you're vomiting. And the friend gets up and says, no, I'm puking. So what Abhishek was stunned with that, when did vomiting become puking? So English is not about just a language. It's about the trend. It's about how you bring out different words, right? So that as a tip for language, being a language evaluator today, I have got a great tip for you. I cannot see the, yeah. Okay. So, very happy. Now, what I'm trying to bring out is that instead of using very happy, what is the other word that you can use? So that is what we learned today. We just have five words. We'll quickly wrap it. But then if you can just, you know, unmute yourself and give me a good word for very happy.
Delighted.
Nice. Very nice. Another example, or I'll just move ahead. Okay. So whenever you want to say I'm very happy, instead of saying very happy, say I'm delighted. I am jubilant. Right? So this is one word, but of course there are many words to it. So pick up the word that actually suits that particular theme or whatever you're talking about. The next word that I have is very worried. I am very worried today. Any other word that you can give me for it?
Tensed.
Sorry? Tensed. Very nice. We can also use...
Anxious.
Right. So I am anxious today. My son has not called me as yet. I am anxious, you know. Okay. The next is very clean. Well, I went to that mall and it's very clean out there. What could be the other word that you can use?
Spick and span.
Spick and span. Beautiful.
Neat and clean.
Neat and clean will be again two words. We can also use spotless. Spick and span is actually a phrase or an idiom that we can use. We can use spotless. So I went to her place and it was spotless, you know. And as you said, neat and clean is of course, but it's something not that replaced very clean. Very short. And this is not about the height that I'm talking about.
Concise.
Right. Very short. Downsize will be something that you bring down, right? Okay. Instead of very short.
Tiny.
Yeah. So instead of very short next time, use brief. The story was, the story as, or you know, he briefly told me about his story, something like that, right? So he told us a very short story. Well, he briefly narrated his story, something like that. The next is very cold. This is simple. Come on. I want more words for this.
Chilling.
Chilling. Very nice.
Freezing.
Freezing. Beautiful. And yes, I do have the word as freezing. So it was freezing cold. Or, you know, I was freezing there. I was feeling very cold. No. Say, I was freezing. So, you know, this this replacement brings in that style in your writing. And, you know, you have lots and lots of materials on the net. And if you actually start going through, it'll help you. So, yeah, thank you. And... yeah, that's all from my report, Toastmaster of the Day, Ritija. Thank you for giving me an extra time. Thank you.
Thanks a lot for that report, Toastmaster Hina. I'm sure everyone got to learn a lot from it. And we hope to see more people use these words and make the quality of speeches even better. So now we have the R-Counter report. I'd like to welcome Toastmaster Vinoda to give us the R-Counter's report.
Madam President, Toastmaster of the Day, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, good afternoon. I am Dr. Vinoda, presenting here the R-Counter report. Let me share my screen. Can you all see this? Can you all see my screen?
Yes, your screen is visible.
Yes. Let us congratulate PM Abhinav as if flawless speaker. And speaker TM Raghavendra used 5 plus R's, 1 2 but, and 3 so. Evaluator TM Vinod used 3 R's. TM Rituja, 5 plus R's, 3 ums, 2 but, 5 so and 1 you know. Language evaluator TM Hina used 5 plus R, 1 2 and, 1 well, 2 so and 1 you know. General evaluator TM J, okay. Resident TM Hina used 5 plus R's, 3 oos and 3 so. Table topics, PTM, PM Swati, 2 R's, 2 and 3 so. PM Arshada, 5 plus R's, 1 and 1. Then TM Shantanu, 5 plus R's, 3 and Prathamesh, 1 R, 2 and TM Manoj, 1 R, 2 and 2 so. That's all is the report. Over to you, TM Modi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vinoda, for your report that you've presented to us. Now, someone was watching, was observing the proceedings of the entire meeting. He will now give us his comments. Over to Toastmaster Jay, who is the general evaluator for today's meeting.
Yeah, thank you very much to Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ritija. Good afternoon to all of you. Now I'm here with my report. As a general evaluator, my role is to evaluate all the role players and the speakers in general. But I will not evaluate the speaker because speaker is already evaluated by the evaluators. So now let me go ahead. So we can start with Sergeant at Arms Toastmaster Abhinav. Toastmaster Abhinav, super. You started the meeting bang on the time. You explained the rules. You took the guest feedback. But I think you missed. There was one guest and you forget to take the feedback from them. A part of this mission of our club, well explained, rules well explained, no more improvement. Only this recommendation, you can check the participant list and then take out the guest. Presidential address. Today, I don't know it's a technical glitch from my side or how, because I think there was no any presidential address today. Next role player is the grammarian. Our president Toastmaster Hina took this responsibility and did the job really very well. Word of the day, phrase of the day was prominent as per the meeting. And that's the best suited to our community. You explained the usage. You requested the other members to thumbs up and always try to use in your speeches or whenever you are speaking in a meeting. You explain good and not so good. And a part of this, you requested so some extra time so that you can give more or you can deliver more to the participant. Kudos to you. No recommendation. Next is our counter. Our counter Toastmaster Vinoda, your role was flawless. Each and everything was perfect. You clearly mentioned our ohms, who did well. And one recommendation only. This Toastmaster Manoj is actually Toastmaster Manu from PTMC. And one more recommendation I can mention here. No need to mention Toastmaster Hina at the language evaluator Toastmaster Hina for the table topic. You can just use one line for one person. Because that he has to improve or she has to improve. A part of that, perfect, no more recommendations. Timer, Toastmaster Abhishek, your slideshow was very well. Only one time you had one technical glitches and I think that was because your battery was drained out. So in the next meeting, you can just fill it up so that you can manage all these things. The timings were well, so no more recommendation from my side. Perfect. Table topic master, Toastmaster Swati. You explain the rules, easy and relevant topics. You are confident and energetic throughout the session. You try to engage the guest and the senior Toastmaster together and very well conducted the oral sessions. No more. I had said there is no any recommendation for you. Very well. Now coming to the speech evaluation. Distinguished Toastmaster Vinod, you evaluated speech for Toastmaster Raghavendra. You use CRC approach and there is no any recommendation. You did the job really very well. Now the Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ritija. You continuously send the role availability mailer throughout the weeks. Whenever someone dropped out, you assigned the next role player on the spot. Agenda was on time. Proper introductions. Meeting progress sync with the agenda. Perfect. Throughout the energy was super. Only one point which I want to highlight here. In the agenda, timer role was missing. So maybe next time we can have a look on the agenda and then we can do better. A part of this, I enjoyed this meeting thoroughly and I learned a lot. Definitely I learned a lot, like what are the words which we can use, not very cold, we can use freezing. Or the next last moment statement, which Toastmaster Manu said to us, that will always remain with us. So these are the thoughts, these are the genuine thoughts, natural thoughts are always welcome in this Toastmaster family. And I hope we will take all these takeaways, not only these, more takeaways from with us. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ritija. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jay, for your report. We will, since we're towards the end of the meeting, I now call upon Toastmaster Hina for recognizing and appreciating the excellence of all the role players and the table topic speakers. Toastmaster Hina, please, if you could come forward to give the certificates to the winners and give your closing address.
Sure. Thank you, Toastmaster of the Day, Ritija. Okay, let us start with the guest feedback first. We have guest Harshada. Harshada, would you like to let us know your experience and how did you feel the meeting was? Did you enjoy it?
I definitely thoroughly enjoyed the meeting and I'm really happy that I attended this meeting. Throughout, there was a good sense of zeal in the meeting. I really liked the way each of the role players conducted their roles. And the way each of the sessions, delivery evaluations went. So really great job, everyone. Thank you so much for having me in this meeting.
Thank you, Harshada, for attending the meeting. We do look forward to have you more, your presence to further meetings as well.
Thank you.
Okay, we have Prathmesh. Prathmesh, hello. How was your experience today? And share your feedback with us.
Yes, definitely. It was a good session and meeting. Your analysis helps a lot in understanding our weaknesses and our strength, and it will be a great team, and I am looking for improvement in me as well. Thanks for having me in this meeting. Thank you
Prathmesh, for attending the meeting. We will have a guest briefing session after this meeting, and we can talk more about, you know, about Toastmasters and about what journey we would like to pursue.
Okay.
Manu, hello. Good afternoon. So how was your experience, Toastmaster Manu, with the Northwest Club? So Toastmaster Manu, if you're trying to speak, you are mute.
Hi. Thank you, President Hina. It's always a pleasure to be a part of Northwest meetings. It is our extended family. I've attended after a long time and I thoroughly enjoyed the session.
Amazing.
Look forward to attending regularly in upcoming weeks.
Great, great. And we too were surprised to see you and great to have you as part of our meeting today. Thanks for attending, Toastmaster Manu. Okay, and how many of us have seen the movie Sharabi? Amitabh Bachchan, please raise your hand. I see the videos on, so we can raise our hands. And there's one scene out there where Jayaprada is on the stage and she sees that the entire audience, you know, no one is there but Amitabh Bachchan. She's disappointed, but Amitabh Bachchan made sure that she enjoys her performance even with a single person there. So today we do have, you know, a lesser number of audience with us, but we as a team made sure that our 2 hours today are full of learning, full of zeal, and we actually get to have both, or best of both the worlds. So thank you all for, you know, making sure that whenever we are attending meetings, we are fully, fully into it. And with this, I come to the announcements. So we have conducted our elections. Our XCOM is there, who will be taking the charge starting January. This entire month will be the knowledge sharing and knowledge transition months. So I would request all the new members to please get in touch with the current XCOM and make sure your knowledge transfer, or, you know, whatever you want to know, is completely done. Thank you. And Yes, so that was for the announcement part, and we come down to the awards and the ceremony. So today we had one speaker. Thank you, Raghavendra, for taking the speech slot. So kudos to you. Thank you, DTM Vinod. We don't have our we didn't have the voting today for speaker and evaluator, but you. So both of you are the winners. Okay, and moving on to the best TT speaker. So the best table topic speaker, would you be sharing the screen? Yeah. Okay, so best table topic speaker goes to Toastmaster Hina and Toastmaster Manu. Best role player award goes to Toastmaster Ritija and Toastmaster Vinoda. Congratulations. Thank you for the way you've played the roles today. Well, today everyone was stupendous, you know. Everyone was very good. Not very good. Zivalent. So, yeah. But then we have to give the awards. So, the best role player goes to Toastmaster Vinoda. Yes. Yes, ETM Vinod.
As soon as you complete, so it's a privilege for every incoming president to give 2 minutes speech. So, we should not... take a chance from the Jai Singh to speak, and we'll invite, of course, for 2 minutes speech.
Sure. Yeah, so it's over to you, Toastmaster Jai.
Definitely, sir. I will be happy to share my thoughts and my opinions about it. So first, I want to say a big thanks from my heart from distinguished Toastmaster Vinod, then Toastmaster Manpreet, and now the Toastmaster Hina. They all did a really fantastic job. And now, actually, I was surprising, how can I take it? What should I do to take this legacy forward? But after having this election, and with the help of Toastmaster Swati and my definitely super team, I have the confidence, yes, we can do this. Not only because we have a legacy, we have one team, but the team, how this team is made by. There are super experienced Toastmaster Swatis with us. That's the one point. Second, we have Toastmaster Venkatesh with us. We have other Toastmaster who are super and every time perfect, impromptu, and always ready to support. And this club is working on the support systems. So that's the reason I can say yes. Definitely the next team will give you the best result as per their capability. And today, this as the Toastmaster Hina and our president announced, now we have two XCOM. One XCOM who is doing the transfer, and the second is the taking. And all the Toastmaster who are available right now in this meeting or in this club will take the benefit out of these two words, best of the two words. That's all from my side. Let's get together and then rock the floor again and again and then come back. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jai. We are now good to close the meeting. I would request the guests to stay if you can have a briefing of Toastmasters, and if they have any queries, they can certainly ask. And I'm not the host, so host may please also stay as the meeting will close.
Yeah, I'll transfer the host settings. Can everyone please switch on the camera once so we can take a picture? Toastmaster
Manu, Abhishek.
Abhishek, a camera.
Okay, smile everyone. All right. Thank you everyone.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Have a great week ahead.
Madam President, can we leave?
Hanji.
Thank you, and all the best to the newly XCOM members. We are definitely there to support you all. All the best.
All the best.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Vinod sir, and thank you everyone. And thank you, Toastmaster Hina.
Thank you.
Raghavendra, you can also stay. Huh? Hello, Pratmesh. So, you like the meeting today?
Hello. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. So how did you come to know about Toastmasters, Pratnesh?
Through YouTube, one of speakers the koi to unke
okay. Good. So what is your expectation? Why do you, if you actually wish to join Toastmasters, what would be your reason to?
Basically, I want to improve my leadership skills. Secondly, the communication and public speaking. How to deliver the speech effectively, persuasive, and influence people's impact through our speech and words. That's the whole point of my joining the club.
Okay, okay. Do you want to know a little about Toastmasters?
Yeah, why not?
It's 1 o'clock.
Okay, so Toastmasters is basically an organization. It's an international organization. It's been here for more than 145 years now. The main purpose is to improve your public speaking skills. So whenever we had joined, so like I had joined around, 2 years, 1.5 years back. So whenever we joined, all of us had the same intention to improve our communication skills, to improve our public speaking skills. And that is how it helps. You saw the meeting today. That is how the meeting goes every time. You will have a set of prepared speeches. Like Raghavendra gave his speech today, so he was prepared with that speech. So whatever speech you will give will be evaluated on your language skills, on how did you deliver the speech, and many other things like ahs and ums and all other things, right? And that is how you improve yourself. So it's basically a self-service thing. You give your speech, you take the feedback from everyone, and then you improve in the next speech. You make sure your points pehle galtiyan thi, wo galtiyan aage na ho.
Okay.
That is on you, move ahead. And to ensure that you have a good path to follow, that kahan se start karna hai, kahan end karna hai, matlab in the entire journey. Toastmasters has different levels, then it has different pathways. Pathways ka matlab, jaise agar you want to improve your leadership skills. So leadership ka ek pathway hota hai. Mujhe presentation skills improve karni hai, to ek presentation ka pathway hota hai. Deni sab mein speech hi hoti hai. But the way the speeches or the titles or the crafting of the speech, वो आपके pathway पे depend करता है. और हर pathway में they have 5 levels. Starting from level 1, when you join, you eventually move to level 5. Okay, so that is how the entire process goes. Right. So you have joined. You have seen any other meeting? You have been a part of any other meeting before?
No, no.
किसी और club का या?
नहीं.
This is the first. Yeah. So with online, अभी जब तक है कोरोना का and all, we will be online. Otherwise, we have our meetings in Pimple Saudagar, SNBP International School. So we meet there every Sunday, and the meeting happens in the school there every Sunday. But by the time it is not happening physically, we will be having our virtual meetings. And about the fees, so Toastmasters has two types. One is your registration fee, which is one time fee. That is, you pay ₹1,800 as a one time fee, and it's there for it's lifelong fee. So if you are today, you enroll with us, tomorrow you may go to America, you want to join a Toastmasters club in America, you don't need to pay a registration fee again. Then what you need to pay is the club fee. So every club can charges its own fee based on its developed structure. So we charge $675 per month.
$675
monthly. You pay in one chunk for 6 months. So like if you pay in October, you pay it for till March month. So you pay 6 months together. Then you pay in April till September. Okay. The next 6 months. ऐसा payment structure रहता है. And उस तो Toastmasters actually also takes a monthly fee from there. तो क्लब का थोड़ा अपना एक्सपेंसेस, जैसे कॉन्टेस्ट होते हैं क्लब में, जब फिजिकल मीटिंग्स होती हैं तो फिर वी हैव फेलोशिप्स और वी हैव थोड़ा स्नैक्स रखते हैं हम लोग, या फिर सर्टिफिकेट्स देते हैं. वी गिव अमेजोन वाउचर्स. अभी इन ऑनलाइन मीटिंग्स वी आर गिविंग अमेजोन वाउचर्स टू द विनर्स और हूएवर विल.
आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
हेलो.
यस, अभी आ रही है.
तो इसलिए वी हैव क्लब एक्सपेंसेस, टोस्टमास्टर एक्सपेंसेस. तो टोटल आपका हो जाता है 1800 एज द वन टाइम रजिस्ट्रेशन, एंड देन 4200 समथिंग आता है आपका 6 months का. सो वी कैलकुलेट 675 इनटू 6 करके आप करना. तो ये होता है. सो लेट मी, इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी.
यस यस. मैं सातारा से हूँ, तो कौन सा क्लब लेना चाहिए इसके लिए सोच रहा हूँ, क्योंकि हाउ कैन आई अटेंड देयर फ्रॉम सातारा.
ओके, सो उसमें ऐसा है, इफ यू लाइक दिस क्लब फॉर एग्जांपल, अभी ऑनलाइन है तो नेक्स्ट सिक्स मंथ्स तो हम ऑनलाइन है, सो यू कैन ज्वाइन दिस क्लब फॉर एग्जांपल, एंड आफ्टर सिक्स मंथ से लॉकडाउन खत्म हो जाता है अपना, यू नो स्कूल्स वगैरह सब स्टार्ट हो जाते हैं. So then you can choose a club near Satara. Raghav, would you know which club would be suited for him near Satara?
I'm not aware of any club in Satara, but there is a club which is in forming in Kolhapur. It's on progress that they are taking demo meetings and everything, but I'm not aware about that club. But so far, but I'm not aware is there club in Satara itself.
Okay. So Pratmesh, once you decide to join, you can always you know just search for the club nearest to your place. Google कर सकते हो आप. नहीं तो we can find out someone for you who can you know guide you which club would be the best club to for you to join. तो वो होगा. बाकी जब तक online है तब तक तो you can actually be you know. Other thing is if you have joined this club, you can attend meeting or you can give speeches in any club. Just have to go and talk to them कि मुझे speech देना है. I am a member of this Northwest club. So आप open है, आपको आप कहीं भी जाके attend कर सकते हो. Like Toastmaster Manu, he is not part of our club, but he wanted to attend. He attended today. So इतना freedom होता है आपको कि आप कहीं भी speech दे सकते हो, आप कहीं भी you know attend कर सकते हो.
Okay.
Yes, yes. Any other question, Pratmesh?
तो सातारा में शुरू करने क्लब शुरू करने के लिए क्या प्रोसीजर है मतलब?
सतारा में शुरू कर सकते हैं, लेकिन आई थिंक इतने वो मेंबर्स चाहिए वहाँ पर, मिनिमम 20 मेंबर्स चाहिए व्हेनेवर यू वांट टू स्टार्ट अ क्लब.
ओके,
फिर आपको यहाँ पर हेल्प करते हैं. सो यू हैव एरिया डायरेक्टर्स, यू हैव डिवीजन डायरेक्टर्स, जो भी सतारा जिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट में भी जिस डिवीजन में पड़ेगा उसमें दे विल हेल्प यू, बट यू नीड मिनिमम 20 मेंबर्स टू स्टार्ट अ क्लब.
और आपका जो क्लब मीटिंग अटेंड होती है जो फिजिकल अटेंड है वो संडे को ही होती है या सैटरडे संडे, मतलब क्या है?
हमारी संडे को ही होती है 11 टू 1, बाकी अदर क्लब्स हैव अदर टाइमिंग्स. सो या
अब मुझे संडे को ही पॉसिबल होगा.
हां वो सबको ही होता है. ठीक है, सो माय सजेशन टू यू प्रतनेश इज अटेंड वन और टू मीटिंग्स, ऑनलाइन मीटिंग्स आप अटेंड करो एंड देन यू कैन डिसाइड कि हाउ डू यू फील. इम्प्रूवमेंट होता है, दैट इज फॉर श्योर, हम सबका हुआ है. धीरे धीरे होता है पर होता है.
ओके,
यू नो आप मतलब खुल जाते हो, आप बात करना ऑन लाइक आवर टोस्ट मास्टर ऑफ द डे रितिजा, यू नो हु कंडक्टेड द मीटिंग, ही वाज सो गुड. सो यू लर्न ऑल दोस थिंग्स आल्सो, सिर्फ ऐसे नहीं आपको मीटिंग कैसे कंडक्ट करना है, टाइम कैसे मैनेज करना है, बहुत कुछ सीखते हो आप जस्ट बीइंग इन टोस्ट मास्टर्स. या एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट हियर इज दैट गलतियां करना अलाउड है. So, where you were working somewhere or student?
Yeah, working. Construction site.
Sorry? Construction site, Satara. Okay, okay, good. So, Pratmesh, do let us know. What do you think? Yes. आप अगर Google करोगे, आपको phone numbers भी मिलेंगे, जिससे आप बात कर सकते हो. And attend couple of meetings here. We will add you to the guest group. Are you part of guest group?
No, not yet.
Can you give us your phone number?
Okay. 96.
एक सेकेंड. हाँ जी, 9665 999 653 653. ठीक है प्रथमेश ना?
यस.
तो वी विल गेट यू एडेड टू द ग्रुप, आपको मीटिंग की डिटेल्स आ जाएंगी वहाँ पर. अटेंड करो आप एक दो और मीटिंग एंड देन आप.
Have a good day.